In the name of Allah, the entirely merciful, the specially merciful. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah the Almighty be upon all of you. I am Umar bin Abid and you are watching Umar Linguistics. And this is lecture 14, Talking to Animals. So in the previous lectures, we were discussing properties of human language like cultural transmission, productivity, duality, arbitrariness, and a few more. And in all these properties, we came to the point that these are only human beings who could produce language, or these are only human beings whose language have properties like productivity, duality, and a few other properties. And we also discussed that language is culturally transmitted in human beings and not in animals. And it seems impossible that animals could produce something like language like human beings, or they could understand humans' language. But the case is that there are some people, there are a few people who don't behave that this is the case, and they think that animals understand human language. And we are going to discuss that what they say or what examples they give that no, animals could understand human language. So their claims are, for example, they say that when horse riders say "whoa" to their horses and the horses stop, so it means that horses are understanding human language. Similarly, they give example like if we say to our dog "heel" and they will follow at our heel and they come at our heel, so doesn't it mean that dogs are understanding human language? Similarly, a few other examples, for example, in circus you may have observed that you can say the animal is moving on different instructions. For example, when he or she say up and the animals go in the upward direction, when they say down and the animal go down in downward direction, and when they say roll over and the animal starts rolling over. So doesn't it mean that animals could understand human language? So actually there is a general explanation that why these simpler words or these instructions could not be considered as language. And the reason is that animal produces these particular behavior in response to a sound stimulus. They don't understand that what "wa" mean, what "up" mean, what "go" means, what "down" means. If they understand, then any animal should move in the upward direction if we say "up", but it doesn't happen. And inversely, it is possible that I have trained and or you have trained or someone have trained an animal, and when he or she says to it that "go upward", and that animal is going in downward direction because he or she has trained that animal in this way, that upward mean to go downward, upward mean to go some downward, and downward mean to go upward. Or for example, they may say their animal, they have trained their animal in a way that for example, "oh", and that animal going upward. So why that animal is going upward if he know that "oh" mean is something else? So actually they are responding just to a sound stimulus and how they are trained. And now these are what we said, like "wa" or "up" and "go", and these are the examples of just English. But in other cultures there are different words. For example, in my culture, in my language Urdu, people say different words to their horses and their horses start moving, and people say different words and different sounds, produce different sounds to their pets, and their pets start following them, like "pommy", and come, o, a, e. So in this way, and their pets start following them. So animals would have understood something like humans' language, so they must produce their direction, or they must understand direction according to how humans are understanding language. But actually it is not possible and it is not observable. And this was about humans and animals, but we may observe that even animals of one species does not sound of another species. And example is that, yeah, that you may keep your horse in a field with cow, in a field with cows for several years, but your horse will never produce any sound like meh, meh, like, or moo, like the cow are producing sounds, cows are producing sound. So your horse will never produce such a sound. So how is it possible that animals produce, or animals understand human language, when they are not understanding language? Or maybe they understand language of another species, but they are unable to produce those sounds as well. And one example is that in some homes, a puppy and a child, or a cat and a child, may arrive at the same time. A puppy and a baby, a new baby, arrive at the same time. And both the baby and the puppy hears same sounds. Both have, you can say, equal opportunities to communicate with other human beings. Or puppy is also listening those sounds which a child is listening. Or if there is a cat is also listening those sounds which a baby is listening. But only baby start producing some sounds and words after after a very short period of time. But that baby or that pet cat or any other animal which is also living with that baby is unable to produce any kind of words or any kind of sounds like human beings. So this is all about today's lecture, and we will continue this lecture for talking to animals in the next lecture as well, when we are going to talk about chimpanzees and language. Because some people consider, because even it's just a Darwin's theory, that chimpanzees are closely relative of human beings. So let's discuss that. Does chimpanzees could understand, are able to understand human language or not? So this is all about today's lecture, and in the next lecture we'll talk about this topic. So I hope you would have understood something, and if you find out any pros and cons, so you may point out that in comments box. So don't forget to give your feedback. Remember, in your prayers. Jazakallah khairan, and thank you.